Good afternoon to all of you. Recently, the Honorable Supreme Court of India, in the case of Karmuru Rogaramakrishna Raju, MP, Narsapuram, held a time has come where the Supreme Court has to define the limitation of sedition. You may be knowing, sedition cases will be booked under Section 124A of the Indian Penal Code. In other words, if anybody tries to incite, attempts to incite the people to rebel against the democratically elected the government, to overthrow the government by their speeches, by their acts, yes, they can be booked under sedition law. But please remember, Supreme Court has very clearly stated this RRR case also. A man can condemn anything, a man can criticize to any extent, but that incitement, that criticism should not go beyond the line, because democracy requires dissent, democracy requires criticism, then only the party in power or the ruler, definitely they will know what are their difficulties. Now, another case, even the matters were like that, another case of sedition was booked against a filmmaker, I think she was also a cinema actor, Ayesha Sultana. Recently, she participated in a Malayalam TV channel, and while delivering her speech or comments, she sarcastically commented that the central government has used a biological weapon on Lakshadweep. So the innuendo or internal meaning of the sarcastic comment is that the central government has sent the present administrator, Mr. Praful K. Patel, who was the ex-home minister of Amit Shah of Gujarat. And of course, he is already bringing a series of latest laws in Lakshadweep. Of course, the people who are much dependent on fishing and who are mostly Muslims, they are antagonistic to this. No doubt, Mr. Praful Patel, actually, he wanted to reform the Lakshadweep and he wanted to make it a tourist hub, just like Maldives. So he wants to give permission. So he has actually enacted so many things. But the problem here is, I think 1 year back, he took charge as the administrator of Lakshadweep. Actually, normally, IAS officers will be posted. We don't know why this man was sent to Lakshadweep. And after coming there, previously, there were nil COVID-19 cases. Out of 70,000 population, the COVID-19 cases was zero. But after he said, actually, the rule was, if anybody visits Kavaratti or Lakshadweep, they have to be in isolation for 14 days. So first of all, he waived the 14 days quarantine rule. Anybody can come and anybody can do at whatever point of time. As a result of which, out of 70,000 population, now 7,000 are affected with COVID-19. That is, he is responsible according to them. And secondly, very recently, he wanted the intelligence people to go in the ships and boats and collect information. That was a very vague order, arduous order. Of course, later, with the resentment by the other parties, other people, so that order was withdrawn. He has given permission for mining operations. So many things he has done, of course, much to the dissentment of the public. So many various political parties, they have been staging against him. I have made a video also. The funniest part of it is an APP in some island. Of course, Lakshadweep is having 36 islands, out of which some of them are inhabited, some of them are uninhabited, and will be happy if the government, central government, makes the uninhabited islands into tourist hubs, star hotels, if they are established, will be very happy. Just like we can go to, just like Maldives, we can go to this Lakshadweep and enjoy it. But it's not being done. They are giving permission where the people are residing. That's the main problem, right? Now, so people are fed up, of course, literally fed up with attitude, because we have been seeing in the press also a lot of comments, adverse comments. against Mr. Praful Patel. Anyway, so during the discussion, Ayesha, she commented that the center used biological weapon for the spread of COVID-19 in Lakshadweep. That means the center was using the so-called Praful Patel as a biological weapon. So this statement has irked the BJP, and a BJP supporter, right, by name Mr. Abdul Qadir or something else. Abdul Qadir. So he has given a report in Kavaratti police station of Lakshadweep. Case was registered against her under 153A IPC as well as 124A IPC. 124 sedition, 153A hate speech. Peace giving some segregating the political, religious and ideologies, all these things you know. So as per the FIR, her act is anti-national. And she has tarnished the patriotic image of the central government. Right, but of course she defended her words in her Facebook post. She has written, she felt Patel's policies and policies, they are acted or they are taken as a biological weapon. So that's why she commented, and she says that it is a right to comment about the adverse policies. Right, so even some organizations also came in support of this woman Ayesha. Ayesha Begum or Ayesha, stating that Ayesha Sultana, right? So stating that she reacted against the inhuman or approach or immature approach of Praful Patel and also the administrators. Right, I tell you. I have made a video regarding APP. The particular funniest thing is the APP was asked to come to the secretariat in Kavaratti, and he wanted to look after the ministerial work. What is the duty of APP? He has to look after the court work, not this work. So the High Court has come to his rescue, right? Likewise, anyway, recently Supreme Court also has said that it is time for to end. And Kedarnath Singh, please don't forget Kedarnath Singh versus State of Bihar. 1962, I believe. Actually, that has given a doorway to open this 124A. Actually, K.M. Munshi, he wanted to delete 124A as per the constitution. But of course, due to this, after 14 years or so, due to this act only, due to this Kedarna judgment only, once again, the sedition has come into existence. Of course, whatever you say, so many cases are being booked against the people. So this is one such case. Let us wait and see what will happen. Thank you.